Hello there. In this video, we're going to walk through how you can implement DevSecOps workflows within Bitbucket. We'll walk you through our native security scanning tools to help developers identify vulnerabilities before they deploy, and how platform teams can set merge and deployment policies and enforce them at scale across the organization.
Okay, we're starting in the Jira issue we're going to track work with, OBAL 2131. Let's jump over to Bitbucket really quickly. We're going to make some changes to this repository today, and we're going to see how Bitbucket pipelines and Bitbucket pipes can help us deploy and have lots of security scanning and other static analysis. So I've already got this cloned down to my local repository or local desktop, and I've got some stages changed. So let's go take a look at that. So if we take a look, we're in a branch mobile 2131, and if we take a look at our status, we've got some changes made. So if we do a git add minus minus all, we can now jump over to Bitbucket. And we'll take a look at the pipeline. And if we refresh, we should see a pipeline running. There we go. So if we click into this pipeline, we can see the first step is scan for secrets. Then we're going to run some unit tests. We're going to generate a software bill of materials. Then we're going to deploy to AC1 AWS environment. We're going to do some integration tests. We're going to deploy to EU West 2 VS environment, and then we're going to deploy some integration tests. Let's go take a look at that Bitbucket pipeline file now and see how we do some of those things. All right, if we jump to the bottom of this, first thing we can do is take a look at the pipelines we've defined. By default, any pushes to Bitbucket that aren't on the mainline branch are going to run this pipeline. So we see those steps we've talked about. We run unit tests, we generate a software bill of materials, we deploy to CAC1, we integration test CAC1, we deploy to EUS2, and we integration test EUS2. Notice that we don't have the secret scan in here. So if we go back to the pipeline, there's this scan for secret step. This is injected automatically by something called a dynamic pipeline. Dynamic pipelines are a way for a platform engineering team to create pipeline steps that are going to be run on all pipelines in an organization. This allows a platform engineering team to enforce standardization and ensure that every pipeline is up to kind of engineering standards. So in this case, every pipeline that runs in this organization is going to scan for secrets to make sure that no one has put a password or an API key in the actual source code. And this is delivered by a Bitbucket pipe. So no matter what, the developer of the mobile server 12 doesn't have to add this step in here. They don't have to do any work for this. They get it for free. This always happens. And like I say, the platform engineering team can enforce that to happen across all repositories for every pipe that runs. So it's a way of enforcing standards. Now, if we take a look at this deploy test CSE1 step and we hover over this little icon here, it says this is executed on a self-hosted runner. So by default, Bitbucket Pipelines runs all of these steps in the Atlassian cloud on our servers. However, if you have compliance reasons or security concerns, you can run on your own hardware using a self-hosted runner. So basically you set up something like an EC2 box or a server in your data center, you set up Docker on it, and then we provide you with a container that you can point your Bitbucket pipeline at, and it'll run whatever step you've told it to run on your own hardware. So let's go take a look at that Bitbucket pipeline file and see where we add that. So this is deploy test CAC1. So if you scroll up a little bit, and then we find deploy test CAC1, we can see this runs on step. So runs on gives you the ability to say which hardware you want to run it on. So these tags are provided when you create the self-hosted runner. So once that's done and the self-hosted runner is up, you can just tag any step in your Bitbucket pipeline with those tags like this using the runs on command, and you'll automatically get this step executing on your self-hosted runner. Now, if we go down to the next deploy step, it doesn't have runs on. So if we look at this deploy step, there's no runs on here. So in this case, this is going to run on Atlassian hardware. So you can control which steps run on which hardware. So if you have a step that requires specific access to your own data centers or your own data or something, you can guarantee that happens using self-hosted runners. Let's go back to Bitbucket pipelines for a second. So the rest of these steps are going to run out nicely. One other thing I want to point out is this run unit test step. So in Bitbucket, you can specify certain steps to only run when changes have happened to certain branches. So in that case, maybe you have like a large repository or a monorepo, and there's many different disjoint projects in it, and you have maybe a complicated test suite, and you want to run certain tests only when certain branches or sections of your code base have changed. So this is one way of doing that. So if we go over to Bitbucket, we can take a look at this again. If we look at our run unit test step here, you can see that there's a condition, and the change set includes changes to source, slash, and any of the JavaScript files in this directory. So with this functionality, you can basically have specific steps only execute when specific parts of your code base are changed. And again, really useful if you want to run only certain tests when certain parts of your code base have changed, as an example. And let's jump back over to Bitbucket pipes again. And we can see that this is done. All right, now that this pipeline is finished, we're gonna click or create a pull request by clicking on pull requests. And then we're gonna click create pull request. And then we're gonna choose our source branch. In this case, it's selected for us, mobile 2131. We're gonna go /AI to get Atlassian intelligence. And we're gonna ask it to create a pull request description for us. This just saves me some time. I don't have to think about it and write it. Now we can create a draft by clicking create draft. This won't notify anybody that you've asked to review this pipeline. So you can create the pull request, make sure everything works, get it ready, and then notify people to come review it. We're not gonna do that now. We're just gonna click create pull request. And in this case, any reviewers that we add to this would be notified automatically. So if we scroll down, we can see that we've got our pull request, and we've got in our Bitbucket pipeline file, a pipeline that's set up to run whenever a pull request is cut. So let's click pipelines again, and then let's drill into this. And we can see we've got that scan for secret step, which is automatically created by dynamic pipelines. We're also doing an AI code review, a Bitbucket infrastructure as code scan, a dependency scan, and we're running some sneak tests. So let's go take a look at how that pipe is set up in the Bitbucket pipelines.yaml file, and then we'll talk about each of these steps. All right, let's jump to the bottom. If we look at pull requests, we can see that for all branches and all pull requests, we're going to run a few steps. We're going to run an AI code review. We're going to run a Bitbucket infrastructure as code scan. We're going to run a dependency scan, and we're going to run a sneak scan. So if we scroll up and we take a look at, say, this Bitbucket infrastructure as code scan, we can see that this step relies on a pipe provided by Atlassian. This is the Atlassian Bitbucket IC scan pipe, and you basically pass it a path to scan. Bitbucket pipes are prepackaged piles of code that we provide for you to use. There's many of them. I'm gonna show you where you can find them, but you can get a variety of effects from them. All right, let's jump back over to our browser for a second. We're gonna open a new tab, and we're gonna search for Bitbucket pipes. Near the top, we get this a page here, Bitbucket pipeline integrations. We click on this. You come to this page, if we scroll down, we find a list of all the pipes that are available. There are currently 107 pipes available, 17 security pipes, 40 deployment pipes. So if we click on security, we can find 17 different security pipes. So static security testing, Bitbucket dependency scanners here, infrastructure as code scanners here, Black Duck security scan. There's a variety available, so you can find these and use them. If we look at any particular pipe, for instance, this Bitbucket infrastructure as code scanner pipe, you click on it, you're gonna get this page pop up, and it's gonna give you an example of how to use the pipe. It's gonna tell you about all the variables that are available, what you can put in those variables. If you scroll down, you're also gonna find a bunch of examples of how to use it. It's gonna talk about how the pipe works. So each of these pipes implements some specific functionality. The infrastructure's code scanner is gonna look at your Terraform or CloudFormation, and it's gonna make sure that it meets best practices. This particular pipe uses Kix to do that. So Kix is basically an industry standard way of scanning infrastructure as code. If we look at our dependency scanner pipeline, which is another thing we run, you get the same kind of stuff. You get an explanation how to use it, all the variables. This particular pipeline is based on OWASP, another industry standard tool for checking your dependencies. And if we look at this Bitbucket secret scanner pipe that we run, again, explanation how to use it, and this is based on Git leaks. So you can find many, many pipes that do all kinds of things, and you can just use them, copy and paste the code, drop it in your pipeline, and then you can get fully implemented, like industry standard tooling in your pipeline with minimal effort. So as a developer, this saves me a pile of time. I don't have to go learn about each one of these and figure out how to use them and configure them. I can generally grab the Bitbucket pipe and drop it into my pipeline and get most of what I'm looking for. We have lots of pipes for deploying to AWS and Azure as well. So if you want to deploy to the cloud, we've got you covered. So let's go back to Bitbucket now and take a look. This pipe is almost done. Now that this pipe is finished, we can jump back over to pull requests and click on our pull request. And let's take a look at the screen now that's got some updates. So you can see a list of all the builds and pipelines that have run here, and you can click on these to go and look at them in more detail. We scroll down, we can see 5 out of 6 merge checks have passed. So Bitbucket provides a whole bunch of merge checks that you can enable or disable, up to you which ones you use and how you set them up. We've also got a custom merge check provided. This is something else that's provided as part of the dynamic pipeline configuration. So they can be used separately. You can use dynamic pipelines and you can use custom merge checks. And you can use them together. In this case, they're being used together. So this merge check basically makes sure that the secret scan that was injected by the dynamic pipeline runs and passes. So when we go to merge this, this check is going to kick off before the merge actually happens. And it's going to verify that that step was executed and it passes. Now, if we scroll down, we can see a list of tasks that have been added to this pull request. We can see our original Jira issue, OBOL 2131, and we can see some reports. Now, in the center tab here, we can see that an AI code reviewer has taken a look at this and made some suggestions. We've also got a bunch of suggestions over here. So you can have AI parse your changes for you and ask you to do some stuff to make some changes. This just gives you another set of eyes on your code. For each one of these, you can reply to it, you can resolve it, you can create a task. And that'll show up in our tasks. And now our merge check is showing that we are no longer compliant because the task is unresolved. So if we check that, we should go back to good. You can also create Jira issues directly from here. And now we get another Jira issue. We don't have a merge check that checks for open Jira issues. We could have that if we wanted to. Now, if we scroll down, let's take a look at these reports. So if we click on this, we can see that our dependency scanner that we ran in our Bitbucket pull request pipe has detected some dependency problems. We can click into each one of these and drill into them and see more information about them. So we can see that the package stuff cookie before 413 are vulnerable to prototype pollution. So because of this, we can now understand that there's problems and we can make some changes to resolve them. So how you decide to approach these is up to you. Maybe you want to only resolve critical ones, or you might want to resolve all of these, and it's up to your team, but at least now the information is available for you to make decisions. If we click on our infrastructure as code scanning report, we can see we have 2 medium problems. So the ECR image tag is not immutable, and we've got no load balancer set up on our ECS service. So that's something we might want to resolve. And then if we click on security, we can see that we've got 2 security vulnerabilities that have been found. So all of this is available out of the box. You just set these pipes up in your pipeline and you get these scans, and it just lets you know kind of what's going on with your code and helps you run with more secure deployments and better code. All right, so let's approve and merge this. So we click approve. Now watch this step here. This is going to run when we click merge. So we're going to click merge. We're going to choose fast forward. We're going to click merge. And we can see that that step is executing. So we tried to merge, and before Bitbucket lets us merge, it's going to run our custom merge checks to make sure that there's no problems. So in this case, we verify that the scan for secret step is executed, and we verified that it's passed with no secrets found. Now, because we've done a merge, we go back over to pipelines. We're going to see another pipeline kickoff, and this is our pipeline for mainline. This is our production deployment pipeline. So again, we're scanning for secrets because that's injected into all of our pipelines. And then we're going to deploy to production US West. We're going to integration test US West. We're going to deploy to production US East, and we're going to integration test US East. And if we look at over a Bitbucket pipeline file, we can see that those are set up here. So you can set up different pipelines to run for different scenarios. Each branch potentially could have a different pipeline with different steps running. You can make your pipeline's steps conditional based off of what source code has changed. And you can change where they run by providing self-hosted runners. Now, this pipeline paused and it didn't continue. and basically a change request was opened. So if we refresh this a little bit, we can now see we've got a change request. So if we click on this, this is going to take us into Jira Service Management, and there's a change request here. Now, because this is a demo, I'm set up to be able to approve this, but in a more realistic situation, your change advisory board would get this change. IT would maybe review it, make sure that everything's on the up and up, make sure that all the necessary steps of running your pipeline and that you're compliant with change management processes your company uses, and then they would click approve. So once they've approved the change request that was opened automatically by Bitbucket, we're going to see that this step will kick off. So as a developer, I can make changes to my code, I can commit, I can push, I'm going to get automatic steps injected by dynamic pipelines. I'm going to security scan my code, do a bunch of static analysis. And once all that passes and I've deployed to my test and staging environments, I can cut a pull request. That's going to run additional scans. And I can then merge into our production branch. But before it goes to production, actually deploys, we can kick off a change request and have our change advisory board double check to make sure everything's good before the final deployment. And then we can go to production. Now that the pipe is completed, let's take a look at our Jira issue. We refresh this. We can see that we've got some stuff added to the development panel. So if we click in here, we have a link to our branch that we made. We can see the commit that we made. We can go to the pull request. We can see our builds, and we can see deployments that have been done.
All right. Thank you for watching this video about DevSecOps in Bitbucket Cloud. To learn more about any of these features, please view our documentation linked below in the description. You can find more videos like this in the Developer's Edge video series on the Atlassian YouTube channel.